In the same way that a doctor can do anything from delivering babies to curing cancer to giving you breast implants, actuaries actually do a lot of things. In part one of my What Do Actuaries Actually Do series, I asked you guys to give it a thumbs up if you wanted to see a part two, and you guys crushed 200 thumbs up. So here in part two of What Do Actuaries Actually Do, I will be talking about reserving. Give this video a thumbs up if you want to see a part three. If we crush 200 thumbs up, I will gladly sit around and make that video for you guys. Now, you might know reserving in the context of, oh, sorry, I'm reserving this seat for my friend, but you might not have heard of reserving in the context of money. Simply put, insurance companies are reserving money for people that they're gonna have to pay money to. Let's say you made and sold whale statues, which is a real thing that sits in my living room. First, you spend $10 on materials, $10 on labor, you sell it for $40, boom, $20 profit. You can take that profit and just like, make it rain. You can get it in dollar coins, because we live in Canada and we don't have dollar bills. You can roll around in them, like you can do whatever you want with that profit. Now, while I'm emphasizing the profits, the important thing to notice is the timing. First the costs, then the profit. Step one, outflow of money. Step two, inflow of money. With an insurance company, it's the opposite. First, we sell you an insurance policy, which means that the insurance company gets all the money. Then later, you're gonna have an accident, or your house is gonna burn down, or whatever it is, and we're gonna have to pay you money out. We need to set aside a portion of that money to make sure that we can pay you what we owe you. This is a question of both, how do we declare profitability? But also, how do we make sure that we don't go bankrupt? How do we make sure that we have enough money for you guys? Your average insurance company is selling more than one policy, and at any given time, they probably have tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of people that they could potentially have to pay money to. Right now, there are people who hold policies, have not had an accident yet, but will have an accident before the policy expires. We need to hold money for that. You also have people who have had an accident, haven't told you about it yet, but you're still gonna have to pay out the money. Let's say you got into a car accident, but your car is still drivable, so you haven't bothered to call your insurer yet to get it repaired. You've also got people who've had accidents, told you about them, you've set money aside for them, maybe you set aside, I don't know, $5,000, $10,000 for them, and then it's gonna end up costing $30,000 because for whatever reason the accident ends up costing more than you had initially thought. And it's the actuary's job to determine how much of the premium that the insurance company is collecting should be put aside to be paid out into losses, to pay for your burnt down house, to pay for whatever it is that you had happen to you in the accident process thing. Cool. Now I'm gonna take a minute here to explain to you one way that someone could hypothetically determine reserves. When actuaries determine the prices for insurance, they can make assumptions as to what percent of that premium is gonna be paid out to the policyholders. Now let's say we assume 65% goes to pay losses, 30% goes to pay the insurance company's expenses, like infrastructure and salaries and whatnot, and the last 5% is profit. If in 2016 we sold $100 million worth of insurance, that means that we think we're gonna be paying out $65 million in losses. Sold 100 million, we think 65% of it is gonna go to losses, 65 million in losses. Now let's say at the end of 2016, we've already paid out 50 million in losses to people who bought policies in 2016. That means we still have 15 million that we expect to pay out. So that 15 million would be our remaining reserve. The biggest problem with this method would be that it's based off of one initial assumption and does not change based off of what actually happened in the year at all. So if at the end of 2016 we had already paid out more than the 65 million that we had initially thought, we would have no way to know what the reserve was supposed to be. But as a reasonableness check, it's a pretty decent little technique. If you're genuinely curious about other reserving techniques that people are actually using in insurance companies, let me know in the comments and maybe I'll make a video about that. Or just leave me general actuarial questions in the comments, because honestly, I love answering your questions and I try to answer as many as possible. But if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to see more of my face. I put out new videos whenever I feel like it, sometimes about being an actuary. Your thumbs up on actuarial videos tell me that I should make more videos about being an actuary, so I appreciate it. Thank you for calling. Bye.